the Minolta MC Rokkor 55mm f1.7, one of my favorite lenses of all time. When it comes to vintage lenses, it's my definite favorite. It's not only cheap, it's extremely lightweight and it takes sharp images with beautiful bokeh. I first found out about this lens on Philip Reeve's excellent website. He has reviews and example images and everything you want to know about a lot of manual lenses that you can use on your mirrorless camera. I surfed around on this website for quite a while trying to find the perfect 50mm. And if you want something really cheap, I think the Minolta MC Rokkor 55mm 1.7 is probably one of the best value for money you can get if you care about having beautiful bokeh and if you don't need the absolutely sharpest lens. Don't get me wrong, it is very sharp, but there are a few other 50mm lenses out there that are sharper, but on the other hand they cost a lot more. The first thing you notice when you pick up this lens is that it is extremely lightweight. It weighs almost nothing, and at the same time it feels extremely well built. It feels more well built than any modern lens that you would buy today for 10 times the price of this one. I got mine for $40, but I've seen it on flea markets for even less, so you should be able to pick up one for $30 to maybe $45. The aperture ring is a little bit flimsy and it also lacks a stop between 1.7 and 2.8, but otherwise I really like the feel of this lens. The focusing ring, nothing to complain about there. It has a long range so you can focus conveniently at any distance. And it's smooth. That's quite impressive considering that this lens is almost 50 years old. Let's have a look at some sample shots. First, I want to show you the bokeh. I really like it because it's smooth, creamy, and it has a nice character. And the images are still sharp enough wide open. It's not the sharpest 50mm lens in existence, but it is definitely sharp enough for me. As you can see, the bokeh is smooth. But at the same time, in some shots, you get this nice retro feel that it's a bit hard to get with modern lenses like the size 55. As you can see in this photo, the bokeh rings have a little bit of contour, but I personally just think that is beautiful because it gives this nice retro-ish feeling to the photo. This lens is great because you can use it both for portraits and for landscape shots, and when you stop it down a bit, as in this shot, it is absolutely super sharp all across the frame. So it's also great for landscape shots. If you want to use this lens on a mirrorless camera, you need to find an adapter. And there are a lot of really cheap adapters out there, so just go find one. I've linked one in the description that I use, and it costs like $20 or less. And it's works really great and it complements the lens in the sense that it's lightweight and has a good quality to it. And as you can see, the lens looks really nice on a modern mirrorless camera. It feels well balanced and it feels like it fits the camera. What I like to do, however, is that I put a UV filter and the lens hood that I got with the lens. I'm not sure if it is the original or not, but it's a good lens hood, also made in metal. And with these two, I don't feel the need for a normal lens cap. I just keep them like this in my bag or when I'm out walking, and it protects the lens well enough from scratches or dust and stuff. And removing a minor annoyance, like having to take off your lens cap every time you want to take a shot, actually improves your photography experience quite a lot. That's it for this short review. Please subscribe if you want more reviews or photography tips in general from my channel.